guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, it's going to be the second episode of the Munich guide at Marienplatz. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Some of my favorite places to go and eat and some of the tourist spots that you need to hit if you're in the area. Marienplatz is truly a hotspot for shopping, food, meeting up with your friends. But it's been Munich's main square and city center since 1158, so over 850 years of culture and activity. I kind of cheated with this title because in this episode I'm also going to be mentioning Sendlinger Tor and Karlsplatz. Sendlinger Tor is extremely accessible as well, U3, U6. Sendlinger Tor itself literally stands for Sendling Gate, and it's one of Munich's central city gates. And now once you get out and go straight down Sendlinger Straße, going down this road will literally bring you right into the heart of Munich, into the old town. And now Sendlinger Straße already gives you a precursor as to what will await you in the main hub of the city. Great shopping, great food, cultural stops like this Asamkirche, which is a really beautiful church. And halfway between Sendlinger Tor and Marienplatz is Hofstadt. And right behind Hofstadt is my favorite cafe, O Julia. They have great seating in the summer, as well as great seating for the winter inside. It's really cute and always warm. They have great coffee for like $2.50. So if you just want a quick stop, bite to eat with your friend, come on to O Julia. Anytime I meet up with Haley for anything, we pretty much always end up going back to O Julia. They have great food, staff's always friendly, very nice. It's a mixture of self-service and them coming to you. So you order inside and then they bring your food to you outside. Isn't that nice? And it kind of gives you a sense of being, you know, a little tucked away from the hustle and bustle of the city. But, you know, in the evening it can obviously get a bit busy, which is kind of nice. You never know who you might run into. It's a really cool vibe and I just really love there. They have great antipasti dishes, lovely cakes, and they make the pizza right there so you can watch them if you want. I love O Julia. Moving on from there, once you're already in the area, you might as well pass by Rindermarkt. They have a truly delicious I Love Leo frozen yogurt. I worked there for a day. but yes, now back on our way into Marienplatz, there's the Apple Store and the new town hall, which houses city officials and the mayor. New town hall has a clock which chimes every day at 11 and 12 p.m. and also between spring and fall at 5 o'clock. Once you walk through and get through to the Innenhof, you can have a nice lunch at Ratskeller. In winter you can go downstairs, but in summer you can eat outside and enjoy the little ambiance of the Gothic architecture. I mentioned this in the last video, but going up to Alta Peter is of course a tourist thing to do, but it's great views and, you know, it's a little trek to get up inside, and it's really a cute thing to do if you're in Munich. Be sure to pass by Am Platzl. The infamous German chef Alfons Schubeck has his major restaurant here and a lot of different shops. The famous Hofbräuhaus is also here, so if you're coming by, definitely pass by. It's very big, just, you know, check it off your list. There's also a Hard Rock Cafe and the Orlandostraße. It's a really cute cobblestone street. Now getting back onto the road, this is the Kaufingerstraße that will soon meet with the Neuhauserstraße that leads up to Karlsplatz-Stachus. So there's lots of shopping, street art, performers, different cafes that you can just sit down in the heart of the city. And once you're up at Karlsplatz-Stachus, you'll see the Karlstor, which, like Sendlinger Tor, is one of Munich's city gates. And there's a big fountain that you can just sit by if it's hot. In winter, it's converted into an ice rink. Let's not forget to pass by Viktualienmarkt, where you can get local fresh produce. There's a beer garden that you can sit at as well. And Viktualienmarkt is just a really classic piece of Munich that you should definitely stop by at to get a slice of that Bavarian culture. St. Michael's Church is definitely worth visiting. Really beautiful church, and it's the largest Renaissance church north of the Alps, and was consecrated in 1597. So talk about history. And close by is also Oberpollinger. It's like Bloomingdale's. So you have all the brand names, Gucci, Prada, all that your little heart could desire. And at the top, they have a cafe and restaurant. And in summer, they have a Dachterrasse, so rooftop terrace, where you can eat and take in the beautiful sights of Munich. So I would definitely suggest stopping by. And there's so many little side streets that connect all of these areas together, so you can never really get lost in Munich, which is a really cute thing. And as they say, you have to lose yourself in a city to get to know it. Now that's all I have for you for this video. I really hope that you enjoyed it, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!